sideline, trout line, sitting on a pipeline, waiting for the sun to shine. Snap beans, red beans, cornbread, and mustard greens, that's how we live, and it sure feels fine. Well, you can't change us, that's the way we know. Cajun people live like they did long ago. So join the fun, live off the land, 'cause there ain't nothing better than a Louisiana man. Tightline, trot line, sitting on a pipeline, waiting for the sun to shine. Snap beans, red beans, cornbread, mustard greens, that's how we live, and it sure feels fine.
Hey everybody, welcome to Cajun Living and Cooking. My name is Rodney Dupree, and today we got a neat show. We're in Lutcher. We're at the Lutcher Park for the Lutcher Gramercy Lions Club Couche en Delay. Really, really neat. We got a crackling cooking contest. We got chickens being cooked. We got pork, sausage, dirty rice, all kind of neat stuff. They got a sweet booth. They got a band. They got an auction. A lot of neat stuff, y'all. And Cajun Living and Cooking's fixing to start right about now. All right, y'all, I done found two of the guys that's helping put this together, Patrick and Mike. And how the heck y'all doing, fellas?
Doing great.
Good to be here.
Don't look like the rain's going to spoil this party.
No, not today. We got a big cover over our head, and we need the people to fill it.
Now, this has been going on for 19 years, y'all said?
Yes, sir.
And it's the first time it's been here?
Yes, first time this year.
Okay, and let's talk about what all's going on out here, dude. We got a bunch of crackling cooks.
Yes, we got over 20 cooks. We also have a big auction, as we can see.
Yes.
Different options. Real nice items.
Yes, indeed. Now, I've seen that y'all have a drive-thru. People can drive through and get stuff?
Yes, they can drive right through. People bring it straight to their car, order what you want. And
that's neat. That's neat. It's like McDonald's, y'all. You can just drive up and order what you want.
We also have live music starting at 2 to 6.
Good band.
Kenny Cornette and Killing Time.
Yes, indeed. And in between that is when we'll have the auction with all the neat stuff. Gotcha. I'd like to show that can crusher, man. Can we got that thing here? This is really neat, y'all. It's a homemade can crusher. And the guy donates them every year, huh?
Donates them every year. It's built by Ricky Luke and donated. He does two a year and really a good seller.
Now another neat thing I seen here, y'all, is they got that rotisserie chicken, that big old truck. How many chickens fit in that thing?
Ooh, man, it could fit hundreds.
Gotcha. So you can get your rice dressing plate with pork or chicken on it.
Yes, sir.
And they got the hot dogs, the hamburgers. They got the sweet booth even, man. Oh,
sweet booth. Bunch of sweets.
Now, that's all the local ladies making sweets and bringing them out?
Yes, sir.
Good wow, morning. Y'all. And all right, y'all. Now, where does this money go when all this is said and done?
All the proceeds go to the Louisiana Lions Eye Foundation. And we also have a Louisiana Cripples Children's Camp. That proceeds go to.
Man, so you can't ask for a better cause.
Yes. So it's raining, but we want the support to come out for the kids.
Yes, indeed. And this will be, y'all going to have it at Lutcher Park from now on.
Yes, sir.
Is there a set date every year?
We try the last weekend of March, but it depends on
Easter.
Yeah, pretty much how Easter falls.
All right, y'all. Y'all hearing here, this is good stuff. We fixing to go check on some food. Thank y'all, fellas.
Thank you, man.
All right, y'all, found some of the crackling cooks here. Y'all going to recognize these folks, but let's get their names anyway.
Bonnie Snyder.
Jerry Bourgeois.
Dennis Snyder.
Look like y'all got it going on right here. Y'all into the popping phase.
Yes, we are. We're getting ready to take it out and let it cool off, and then we're going to turn around and stick it back up in there and get all greased about 400.
Yes, indeed. Now, how hot is that grease right now?
Oh, it can scorch you.
It'll get you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he got one of those laser beams there where we can see exactly what's on it.
$2.59.
How much?
$2.59.
$2.59. And that's where you want to be?
Yes.
About $2.50 then?
Yeah.
All right. Well, cool. Well, thank y'all. And I remember y'all from Poche Plantation. Y'all come out second.
Yes, we did.
Yes, indeed. All right, y'all. I'm going to let y'all get back to it.
Okay, thanks.
All right, y'all. I done grabbed one of the crackling cooks. Let's get his name and where he's from.
My name's Rusty Muntz. I'm from Reserve, Louisiana. And I've been cooking crackling for, I guess, about 10 years now. And
now,
last year, I won the crackling cook-off.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. but they only have 5 pots.
Oh.
But I ended up winning, so I was fortunate about that.
Yes, indeed. Well, for people that don't know out there, tell us a quick version of the process on how to cook these cracklings.
Well, what we do, we start off with a tub of lard, and we melt that down, and then we get that to 220 degrees, and then we throw our fat in there, and we let that melt down for about 3 hours. As you can see, it's all
rendered out.
Good and melted. You want to stay at about 220 and let it all melt down. And then as your moisture's getting cooked out the pot, you see the little bubbles? That's all your moisture getting pulled away from the crackling.
So it's cooking the water out.
So you got to get the moisture out. When it quits bubbling, that's when you're good. Then you pull them out and let them cool. And then we're gonna wait a few minutes, let them cool down, and then we're gonna crank it back up to 400 degrees, throw them back in there, and they're gonna pop like pork skins.
Gotcha. So a cool day like this is good.
Yeah.
You want them to cool a little.
But you just gotta make sure the moisture's gone.
Gotcha.
If not, it'll be too greasy.
So
you wanna cook your moisture out of your pot.
All right,
bro. That's what we're looking for.
I appreciate you telling us your tricks, and good luck to you in the contest.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, y'all, look how I done found here, Larry Roussel, but let's get all these other fellas' names, too.
First of all, Rodney, before I tell you about them guys, me and you got to quit meeting in places like this, because your wife, Leslie, and my wife, Gail, going to wonder what the hell's going on, man. But we meet pretty often.
Seems like every cookout, we meeting up together.
That's exactly right, but it's all fun, huh?
Let's get these guys' names.
My name's Joseph Belloc.
Jason Rickerson.
You got good help.
I got good help. We got another help somewhere around Rudy and Mike, my son Rudy, and also Mike found them, the rest of our team, but they right now they're working the crowds, all right?
Gotcha.
They're going to sabotage other pots.
I like that technique. Now, you don't have nothing in here. Where are we going? What are we doing?
Rodney, don't let our competition. We got a two-tiered strategy. One of them, sabotage other pots. Two of them, we buy crackling from a local producer, and now we're ready to go. All right, we'll just put them in toward the end.
Remind me of yesterday at the crawfish balling contest. Like, I asked the guy, I said, what's the secret to your good crawfish? He said, I'm just watching the guy inside of me, and I'm doing what he's doing.
Exactly. And that's what we're doing. We got to give credit, win, lose, or draw. We got two key coaches. We got an offensive coordinator, and that's Andrew Duhay. He's one of the kings out here, and also Balut Snyder with his crew. They're telling us, give us the pointers. We're here helping the Lions Club to make this a successful event.
It's for a good cause. It's what this whole thing's about.
That's exactly right.
All right, Larry, I'm going to let y'all get back to it, bro. I'll see you after a while.
Thank you, Rodney.
Thank you. All right, y'all. I done found a piece of equipment right here, man. I mean, man, you got some stuff in there. What are we pulling out?
Chicken.
Pulling the chickens out?
And pork.
And the pork.
Awesome butts.
All right. Now, how long they been in there?
5 o'clock for the Boston butts and 8 o'clock for the chicken.
All right. They look golden brown, man. That looks really, really good.
Put a little pecan in it.
Oh, the pecan is what pulls it out.
Right. Gotcha.
Well, they fixing to pull them out of here, y'all. This ought to be something to see. Y'all going to pull them out, and they'll go and what y'all do, cut them? Or they look like they're already in portion size.
Put them in a tray and put them back in and let them steam.
All right. All right, y'all. He's pulling them out now. All right, they're going to let us look on it. Look at that, y'all. That's Boston, or that's Boston butts?
Yes.
Man, that looks good. Got a little au jus down in there, a little gravy. Put that on there.
Yes,
man, that looks good. That'll go good on that dirty rice.
Yes, it will.
Now, what's the secret seasoning on those chickens? What, y'all got a rub or something on there? Special little added flavor you put?
We call it Mickey's seasoning.
Mickey's seasoning. You put it together?
No, it's a local bar that put it together.
Oh, all right. They look perfectly cooked. Golden brown there. Oh, we got a secret seasoning here, y'all. We got to get this. Look at there. Lemoines. Season them up. Cajun seasoning. And that's what's on the pork, too? That's on the pork and the chicken. And when we come back, I'm going to show you what's really going on. All right, y'all, it's time again for the steak cook-off. That's right, the steak, pork chop, baked potato cook-off here at Junior's Meat Market. It's June 27th, mark your calendar. It's right here by Moonlight in French Settlement. $20 per category. $20 to get in the steak, $20 to get in the pork chop, and $20 to get in the stuffed potato. You can put anything you want in that stuffed potato, too. We're going to be selling jambalaya plates. We're going to be selling barbecued chicken plates. Y'all come to the steak cook-off and may the best steak win.
Junior's Meat Market has everything you need
when you're going to the camp. Groceries, fresh produce, beer, hoghead cheese, hot or mild, hot cracklings, and ice. Homemade smoked sausage, mild or hot, daily and weekly meat specials, 21-day aged steaks. We can also process your deer. Come on down to Junior's Meat Market and check us out. Gavia's Hardware and Outdoor Cooking is two unique stores in one. The hardware department has everything you need to fix stuff right. The outdoor cooking section cannot be beaten. We have all the latest and greatest gadgets on the market. But also, we keep a large stock of the tried and tested cookware we've all come to love over the years. Coffee and biscuits every morning during the week, cooking demos on Saturdays, and customer service that will help you get the job done. Cuts and Such Hair Salon is a full-service Paul Mitchell-focused salon. We stay up to date on new trends with continuing education through Paul Mitchell. Call or come by and experience a family-friendly atmosphere.
Most homeowners are unaware of existing damage to their homes as a result of hail, wind, and storms. Your home is your biggest investment. You can trust our Hague Certified Inspector to assess your damages and our licensed Louisiana adjuster to maximize your claim. VJ's Construction ensures your claim is settled fairly. Let our team of professionals work for you. Call today to schedule your free, no-obligation damage assessment.
And now, back to the show. All right, y'all, I found some of the ladies out here that really makes this happen. It's the Sweets Booths. We're going to get their name and where they're from.
I'm Doris Laborde, and I'm from a little town called Grand Point.
I'm Cookie Mia, and I'm from Paulina.
I'm Lois Poche, and I'm from Hester.
Ah, a little bit from everywhere out here. Now, where do these sweets come from? You was telling me the Lions Club?
Lions Club, all the wives of the Lions Club member. We asked them to bring something, and this year they really came out.
Before
that, it wasn't required, but at the last meeting, they said everybody has to bring this, so this is what we have.
Somebody put their foot down. Well, y'all got a little bit of everything. Let's tell some of this stuff. What is
Some is pecan pies, some is brownies, some is divinity balls, lemon cake. They got divinity. Ooey gooey.
That's pralines.
Rice
Krispie treats.
Brownies. Chocolate chip cookies. Peanut butter cookies. You name it. We got it.
Woo-wee. I don't know which one I want, y'all. It's really, really nice.
And we are called the bakers of this organization.
Yeah.
When we first started, her and I, we used to make like $150 worth, her and her. But now, it's required every member's wife brings something. We still made the same amount, but they sent, and so we got double the amount.
Gotcha. Well, it couldn't be possible without good people like y'all, and I want to thank y'all for helping raise money for the Lions Club.
Well, thank you.
Thank y'all. All right, y'all. I done found where it's going on over here. Patrick, y'all got it going on with this slicer, man.
Oh, yeah. We got it down to a technique here.
I see that, bro. It's way better than hand slicing.
Oh.
It would take a long time.
Would it?
How many roasts did y'all cook? You know how many?
John Boy, remember how many?
160 pounds.
Wow, that's a lot of roasts. That's some beautiful looking meat. You can see that smoke ring on there. That's what you can really see good. Look at that, man. Lame that over there. Golly, that's succulent. Juice coming out of that, y'all. And that's going to go on the dirty rice.
Yes, sir, nigga. Cover it with gravy.
Woo! It don't get any better than that. All right, fellas, y'all keep up the good work.
Thank you, Dad.
Thank y'all. All right, y'all, they pulling them out the pot right here. Tell me what's going on. They're going to pull them out. That's when you put the seasoning?
Yeah, we just finished popping them and all. Got the temperature up and all. And they're ready to go now.
They look good. That looks like some good cracklings right there. That's that blister on there, they call it. What's the secret seasoning?
Oh, that's
something y'all put together?
No, it's something I buy. I'm not going to say what it is.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
Gotcha.
I can hear them still popping.
Yeah. I cook them a lot and bring them to work. I don't cook competition much, just at the San Francisco Fest. But they come out good.
So. How you feel about them on a scale of 1 to 10?
Oh, these are good. Here, you can look at them.
Yes, indeed. Thank you.
All righty.
All right, y'all, look who I done found out here, Governor Edwards. How's it going?
It's going great. I'm here at the Lions Club cracking cook-off. And although it's raining a little bit, everybody's having a good time because we have a good shed here to cover us.
Yeah, it's nice here at Lutcher Park. This is really, really neat.
It really is. First class. And I must have eaten 15 different kinds of cracking.
I seen that. Some of them put the seasoning, some of them put just salt.
Some have meat, some that don't. But it's very interesting. There's that many varieties of crackling.
Well, what you been doing with yourself? What you been up to?
Well, Trina and I have gotten into the real estate business.
Oh, really?
We got our licenses about 2 weeks ago, and we're trying to get started. It goes a little slow starting, but I like to stay busy. And that's something that I know a little bit about, real estate, and so does Trina, so we're going to give that a shot.
Have y'all sold some lands already?
No, but we got several pieces listed.
You got some listed, so they can call you up and buy some land.
Maybe so.
All right.
I appreciate it very much.
I thank you for coming out and supporting these guys.
Well, I do. I was a Lions Club member years ago, back in Crowley in 1949, 50, 51, 60.
Oh, wow.
When that time. But I got away from it when I went to Congress in 1965. But it's a great organization.
Yeah.
And worldwide, they do a tremendous lot of good for a lot of people. And this club here is very, very active.
Yeah, a good tight-knit club.
Good tight-knit club, hard-working fellows. And they eat well.
Yes, they do. All right, thanks, Governor.
Thank you much.
You're welcome. All right, y'all. We're in the middle of it now. It's getting close to crunch time. Everybody's getting their seasonings on, pulling cracklings out. We got cracklings out the pot over here. We got cracklings out over there. As you look around, they still got a few in the pot here, still turning them over, ready to, he done popping them up, blistering them up. This is crunch time, whatever they like to call crunch time. So we're down to the seasoning, down to the TLC, I like to call it. Everybody's doing their last little bit to get everything going. They got theirs ready. They got some more with seasoning over here. They pulling them out the pot over here. They done got seasoned up. It's getting good now, y'all. We down to crunch time. We right down to the end. We fixing to get a crackling winner here soon. All right, y'all, this is where the action is right here. We got the assembly line going. They pulling the dirty rice out from the end. Man, this looks good, man. And they're getting the coleslaw and the bread goes on. Now, how much are these plates?
$8.
$8, y'all. Look at that. That's a good old gravy right there. Good thick gravy. Yeah.
Assembly line going here.
Perfectly cooked pork. The chicken is golden. Look at that. Y'all, the Lions Club doing it right out here. Filling it up.
100 pounds of rice.
100 pounds of rice, y'all. Wow. That's a good pot. All right, y'all. I'm going to get out their way where they can keep filling these pots up. All right, y'all, I got my fellow judges here, and we just went through this. We're going to get their names and where they're from first.
Trudy Canaggio from Belmont, Louisiana.
Dee Berthelot from Gramercy, Louisiana.
Dennis O'Quinn from Clinton, Louisiana.
Michael Hayden, Clinton, Louisiana.
Mark Anderson, come from Eleanor Anderson.
Stanley Smith from Conway, Louisiana.
Taylor Roussel from Lutcher, Louisiana.
Timmy Roussel from Lutcher, Louisiana.
Man, we got a good diverse group here. Anybody like to talk about how hard that judging was right there?
True crackling with the meat.
One with the meat. We had one with meat. The rest of them didn't have meat.
Well, that's the way I see it. I think the cracklings with the meat on it's a true crackling, and the others a pork skin. I really think it ought to be two separate.
Yeah,
it's hard to judge. You know?
They were all very good.
And some put seasoning and some put salt. You know, I noticed one or two just had salt.
Yeah, the salt is better. than a seasonal, I think.
Yeah, I think so too. I think there was one of them had some crab boil on it and gave it a little bit extra flavor, a little bit extra push.
A little kick on it, a little
like
kick.
Some spice.
Yeah, well, what we want to try is a new dish from St. James Parish called Red Bean Gumbo Cracklin.
Red Bean Gumbo Crack. All right, y'all. Hey, thank y'all. Thank y'all. All right, y'all, this is my fellow judges on this end. The three of us were judging this boxes here. There was three judges judging that, and there was three judges judging the other end. So we glanced at each other's paper, not to talk about it, but it looked like we were all a little bit different anyway.
Well, that's supposed to be.
Yeah. Well, I think it's all a matter of personal taste, because, you know, we might have just grabbed one out of the box to taste it, of course, each of us. So right. It all depends, maybe even sometimes which one you grab.
Right, right. One of them could have had more seasoning on it.
Yeah.
One of them could have been off the back of the batch.
Yeah. So
you don't know. So I believe we picked our guys here. And so I guess they fixed them to scramble up. We're going to take the best ones out of each and we're going to judge them again.
Right. That's what we're told.
Okay. And when we come back, I'm going to show you what's really going on.
RP Custom Trailers and Service is a fully stocked store for RV parts and accessories. With essentials such as tank treatments, hoses, lenses, vents, power cords, cleaning supplies, and everything else your camper may need. Known for customized living quarters and horse trailers for over 18 years. We now specialize in RV insurance work. Talk to Ryan about how to prevent blowouts, and oh yes, that leaky vinyl or rubber roof can be inspected and repaired also. Call or come by and see it all at RP Custom Trailers. Hole in the Wall Seafood and Cajun Meats now has more to offer. The same high-quality seafood, live and boiled crawfish, crabs, sack oysters, frog legs, shrimp, gator meat, garballs, and local catfish, just to name a few. Now selling your favorite smokehouse products, homemade sausage and andouille, beef jerky, stuffed pork chops and chickens, fried boudin balls, cracklings, and much more. Now processing your deer and hogs. And come check out our new seating area. River Rats Bar and Grill, an oasis on the Amite River, located in French Settlement off Highway 16. Hashtag best place to eat and party. With amazingly delicious original and traditional food. Indoor and outdoor seating with a friendly and entertaining staff. Open 7 days a week with happy hour Monday through Friday and game day specials. So come by car, bike, or boat. You won't forget the fun times you've had at River Rats Bar and Grill.
And now, back to the show. All right, y'all. I'm going to get this fella's name, and I might get his name, too.
Yeah. This is Josh Showman with the Lutcher Gramercy's Lions Club.
Man, how long that been on there?
About an hour and a half now. Got about another hour or so to go on it.
Another hour. Man, that looks really, really good. That's good bacon there.
Yeah, it's just a little something extra to give people something to look at and something to taste. You know?
All right. So we're gonna catch up with you when you go to carving on him.
That sounds good, man. See me about an hour or so.
Okay, appreciate it. All right, y'all. I done found the president of the Lions Club out here. I'm gonna get his name and he can say where he's from.
My name's Butch Miette. I'm from Paulina, Louisiana. President of Lutch and Gramercy Lions Club.
Very nice to meet you out here today, man. Y'all got it going on out here. This is really, really nice.
Well, this has been going on for about 19 years.
Yes, sir.
However, this is the first year we decided, because of inclement weather, we moved it to the Lutcher Park, where we have a big, pretty nice pavilion. And as you can see, everybody's undercover.
Everybody's having a good time.
I mean, they are.
You got good food, you got good music, and look like you got real good help.
Good folks is what we call it. Some of the best.
Yes, indeed.
That's why they joined the Lions Club, because this is an organization we do for the needy. Our main objectives in the Lions Club, as you may know, is the Eye Foundation. All about eyeglasses. Eyeglasses for people that can't afford them. We take them in, used eyeglasses. It doesn't matter if you got one frame or not. But we take them in, we send them to New Orleans to get refurbished. And from there, they sent either locally or to the international, which covers about 33 countries.
Wow. Wow, that's amazing. And that's just one thing y'all do.
That's just one thing. Next thing we do have scholarship funds. And our scholarships are not based on just what's your grade point average when you finish high school. It's great. It's, you know, if you have a good grade point average, you're going to get a top school
grant.
Right,
right.
We like to choose people that are really in need of the money and who have the desire to go to college.
Somebody who wants to learn more.
Right, right. And we keep it locally.
Yes, indeed. And that's just some of the stuff that they do, y'all. And what goes on out here is awesome. Y'all need to be out here next year for this. Really, really nice. I want to thank you for talking with me.
Well, I appreciate you interviewing.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
All right, y'all, I was in the washerboard tournament, and my partner was Luke. I don't know where he went, but this is the guys that beat me, so I got to get their names and where they're from.
Devin Duhon from Reserve. Richard Lesh from Paulina.
Y'all kicked our butt. We won the first game. I guess y'all did, too, to play us again. But y'all throw good, man.
It's all in good fun.
Yeah, it is. It's all about the fun. It's all about raising money for the Lions Club, man. Thank y'all, man, for kicking our butt.
Anytime.
Thanks. All right, y'all. I got the winners of the washerboard trophies. We're going to get their names and where they're from.
John Kopernik, Paulina.
I'm Rusty Munch from Reserve, Louisiana.
Bruh. Now y'all are champions. How was the competition, first off?
It was a little stiff, but we took it to them. I mean, they ain't had much in our way, but
gotcha.
We did good.
Gotcha. Now, since y'all won, is there anybody y'all like to thank for that good washerboard throwing y'all were doing?
I
want to thank Miller Lite for helping me get my bearings straight, bro.
And I want to thank Todd Lambert for playing me because he wasn't that good. And Shane Dewey also. And Silvaz also.
I didn't do good in Cracklin this year, but I won the trophy in Holy Board, bro.
All right, fellas. Congratulations to y'all.
Got it, man. Thank you.
Thank
you.
All right, y'all got second place right here. Let's get their names and where they're from.
My name is Josh Silvestre. I'm from Gramercy.
Shane Dewey from Lutcher.
How was the competition, man?
The competition was stiff, but I feel like we did well. And our most recent competition, John Boy Kopernik, if you noticed, when he was holding up that trophy, it said runner-up.
Yeah.
And the reason it said runner-up is because the runner-up, which was me, also won the game for.
He made the winning shot for them.
Gotcha. Now, y'all come out second. Is anybody y'all like to thank for being second? I mean, from your washerboard learning through the years?
I would like to thank them for not coming in second because we were actually aiming for these mugs. We did exactly what we wanted to do. They're not going to be able to drink beer out of those trophies.
Oh, yeah. All right, fellas. Congratulations to y'all.
Appreciate it.
All right, y'all. This is first, second, and third right here. First, second, and third. We're going to get their names and where they from.
Devin Atelier, Lutcher, Louisiana.
Keith Menville, Brittany, Louisiana.
My name is Mickey Bougeron. I'm from downtown Paulina.
Gene Powell, Maurepas.
Chip Roussel from Lutcher, Louisiana.
Kenny Louvier, Gramercy, Louisiana.
Fellas, y'all got out of here early. Y'all did a bunch of good work. It was hard judging, man. I'm going to tell you, it was really hard judging on that. But good job and congratulations to all of y'all. All right, y'all. We had a great day out here in Lutcher at the Lutcher Park. For the Gramercy Lutcher Lions Club, really good stuff, y'all. Good food, good people. Had a great time, y'all. And I want to thank y'all for watching Cajun Living and Cooking. And check us out next week.